So you're sitting in with us for the whole show. Let's get to the rest of the show.
I want to mention
it is Back to the Future Day today.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
Finally, we can stop with the jokes and the fakes and the Photoshop time circuits. As great as this day is, because it actually is Back to the Future Day, it also is the end of that. And my Twitter feed will be like just a little bit less fake funny.
Yeah, like I kind of like that. I mean that it's the end of it. I'm a huge Back to the Future fan.
Hell,
I've said many times it's probably my favorite movie of all time. I think it's not
the,
even
the
just
trilogy
my,
or just like the
no, first,
first
one. The first one. I mean, I love the trilogy too. I'm kind of a Western apologist. Like people say, Back to the Future 3 is not that good. And I'm like, it's really good. It's just
great.
Not that great in comparison.
Oh, yeah.
But my Twitter feed and my Facebook have been blowing up with all these people who are like, Back to the Future. And I'm like, I know you haven't even seen this movie. So I'm glad that like it's going to be over and that the Fairweather fans
like,
won't have anything to post
I like
about.
That we had, you know, that Pepsi came, you know, all the product tie-ins from the original game.
Oh, yeah.
Original game. The original film, Back to the Future 2, have come around now. That we had the Pepsi Perfect bottle get made in a limited run. USA Today.
That was amazing.
Today did the same, like the front page
the actual
treatment.
Cover story of USA Today.
Yeah, which was fantastic.
It was like
and
a wrap.
Right. Yeah, no, it's a fake cover.
Oh,
the rest of the newspaper
I haven't
is the same.
Seen it yet, so
And
it's so well done.
Coolest of all, perhaps, is, you know, because remember, at the beginning of the year, maybe even earlier, Nike teased us and said,
the shoes.
We were going to, like, the Power Laces were going to be a real thing,
so
the Power Lace sneakers. Well, today, they sent a real pair with real Power Laces to Michael J. Fox, who I think might be going on one of the late night shows to promote it and show it off. I'm not positive on that, though, as of this recording. I've just been following his Twitter feed today.
Yeah.
But Nike officially announced them and said that in spring of 2016, so Michael J. Fox gets the first pair, and in spring of 2016, they're going to auction off some amount of them, probably not a lot.
Those guys.
They'll auction them for the Michael J. Fox Parkinson's Research Charity.
Oh, cool.
So I love that, and I love that they're real, but I am a little disappointed. It means
that you can't buy them.
The only place you're – in fact, just today on Twitter, there was a picture of Jeremy Guthrie, a pitcher for the Kansas City Royals, wearing the – remember the replicas they did for like 4 years ago?
Yeah, long time ago.
It was everything but the Power Laces, but they were dead on exact otherwise.
Yeah.
And they did the same thing. They auctioned those and raised like some incredible number, like $9 million for his charity. And so there was a picture on Twitter today of this Kansas City Royals pitcher wearing them in the dugout, you know, as they're sort of just practicing before the game. And, and like I've seen, you know, remember Brian Wilson, the pitcher for the Giants, the crazy eccentric guy. He had a pair. Like, so it's just too bad that
basically you have to play baseball in order to own
Well, they're just going to be they're only going to make it into the hands of like super rich people, and us, you know, normals aren't gonna get their hands on them.
It's hard to be mad at it because they're doing it for charity.
Absolutely.
But it'd be like, I was saying earlier, if they were like $2,500, all of us would be like, should I save that money? Should I waste it for the coolest thing ever? But they'll be like $25,000 or something like that,
probably.
And then none of us will be able to.
I would bet $10,000 a minimum for each pair, minimum. But what I see,
the fact that they exist is pretty rad.
It's
no matter
super rad. What I just wish they would do is auction as many as you want for the Michael J. Fox Parkinson's charity. But how about then do like a limited, take another limited quantity of them, and have like a lottery that for average people where we can, you know, maybe pay $10 or $20 for a ticket for then the chance to buy them at face value, and even the lottery tickets could go to the Michael J. Fox Parkinson's charity.
Pitch it to Nike.
And they'd sell probably a million tickets.
That's a really good idea.
You should be in PR.
At least maybe we could at least have a chance to get them.
There's a free one for you, Nike.
Yeah,
that one's for you. But in any case, so some stuff is real. Oh, and of course, as a former DeLorean owner, I do get a kick out of the fact that the DeLorean is more popular today.
Oh, yeah.
Like today is like DeLorean Day by proxy of it being Back to the Future 2 Day. So
did you actually really own a DeLorean?
I really
for a long time too, like
12
years.
Years
right? Yeah.
12 years.
This,
yeah.
You are an onion with so many layers to discover.
You'll be back, Nathan.
So many layers.
Yeah, it's. I've told the story before, but I was very fortunate. It was my dream car from seeing the movie as a kid, and I was able to get the car because they weren't worth a fortune, and they still aren't a ton of money, but
today they are.
Well, they've gone up certainly.
Literally,
but, just today. Yeah. Today's the bad day. You should have bought one yesterday. But yeah, you know, I was able to buy a house in the San Francisco area, and my wife and I had a kid. So those two things together mean there's not a lot of room for a 2-seat, 30-year-old sort of collector's item thing. And you know, it literally. You were talking about tears in your eyes, you know, buying your game on a shelf. Like when I walked away from handing that car off. Weeping. Yeah. It was a seriously difficult day. Yeah. And today I really missed the car today too, because I wish I could have been a part of it. But yeah, it was a good time. That was good times. I got
a nostalgic day.
Yeah. I got to have, you know, most and what I say is, a lot of guys who are into cars, if they have their dream car, most of them, if they ever get to own it, it's when they're old and gray.
Yeah.
I had it in my 20s. Yeah. Like I got to enjoy it. It was great. So. Happy DeLorean Day, everybody.
Happy DeLorean Day.
It's weird because now, Back to the Future, I mean, after, I guess, tomorrow, technically, Back to the Future happens entirely in the past.
Yep.
Which is kind of weird to think about.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Don't think about that.
Yeah.
while you're also contemplating your own mortality.
I love that
combo will be very depressing.
It's funny because, I mean, I remember seeing all three movies when I was a kid, and I still think of Back to the Future as, like, this, you know, the or Back to the Future 2 specifically is like the future.
Yeah,
like sure, we kind of got things wrong. Like no one microwaves a pizza in a second, and cars don't.
We
fly
should have that. Yet.
Hopefully, no one microwaves a pizza in general.
That's true. Fair point.
3D is all over the place, but you still have to wear glasses.
Oh yeah,
that's true. Yeah, no, Oculus can do it.
Yeah.
There's no just like out in the middle of nowhere, just randomly like drying Sharks. Machines that can like dry your clothes. Although that would be super useful.
You are now dry.
Yeah. Now that's all behind us. It's weird. I was posting in the comments today, and some guy was like, "Wait, so on the USA Today thing, it still shows Marty McFly being arrested or Marty McFly's son?"
Oh yeah.
And they were like, "Wait, so does this mean that?" Doc and Marty failed. And I was like, no, because their caper is happening today. They go back a day before, which is the 21st.
But it already happened because it already.
But right now, on the day, they'd be executing it. Yeah.
All of our heads simultaneously explode.
Just boom, man. Just a red mist covering the walls. But yeah. Happy Back to the Future Day, everybody.
What a good day.
What a good day.
What a great movie.
Yeah.